Hi there. So when Canon came out with the R7, I thought I was going to buy one. The camera looks good. It looks like a very decent package. But you know, then I thought about it, and I realize now that Canon is just confusing. It feels like they don't care about their consumers, their customer base. Right now, you can choose between three Canon mounts: the RF mount, the M mount, and the EF mount. All three mounts exist, and you can buy brand new cameras on all three mounts from Amazon right now. But there'll be no lens development for the EF mount, and there have been only a few lenses for the M mount so far, and it's history of a few years of existence. And even for the RF APS-C bodies, there's not much available right now. And don't blame them, because it's a new, the APS-C system is new. When Canon launched the RF mount, YouTube lauded Canon for the strategy of launching the 1.2 lenses. Well, two of them, yes, just two lenses. The entire YouTube fraternity started talking as if you should base your camera judgments and decisions on the availability of the 1.2 lenses for just two focal lengths, the 50mm and the 85mm. There is still no fast 35mm from Canon. By fast, I mean faster than 1.8. No fast wide-angle lenses, just people creating hype on two uber impractical lenses that one out of 200 people would buy. It doesn't matter, but I guess the bragging right matters more. I mean, I'm talking about people who will probably only buy a 50mm 1.8, that's it. But they want the bragging rights of having a couple of very expensive 1.2s in the system. On the other hand, Canon's 1.8 lenses just don't match the quality of the Nikon Z mount 1.8 lenses, or even Sony equivalent lenses. Nowhere close. They're average, affordable, yes, but cheaply made stopgap lenses. So Canon has pushed people to buy expensive 1.2 lenses if you want that quality. And that 28-70 f/2, which is a great innovation, but it's something very few can afford, and also it's very heavy. And that's the thing, unless you're willing to put down a huge sum of money, you really do not have much in the Canon system. And this is something that I simply do not appreciate. I don't relate with that strategy. Because you see, when you pay top dollars for something, quality and finish are just expected. It becomes a basic expectation. Then great quality, at that those price points, great quality is something that should not delight you, because you expect that level of performance. It only begins to match the value of the price tag when the lenses are $2,000 plus. But hey, if you want a really good 85 1.4 on the Canon system, what do you do? Because 1.4 lenses are 66% or 2/3 of the way in terms of light gathering and aperture, you know, if you want nice bokeh, of an 1.8 lens. And what if you want that to be affordable? Does Canon make one? No. Samyang does. But Canon stopped Samyang or Rokinon from producing those lenses anymore. How wonderful. And just this week, we learned that Canon stopped Viltrox from making lenses for the RF mount. I mean, that's pure protectionist, anti-capitalist bullshit. So every time you come on YouTube, you see people comparing the R7 and R10 against ZV-10 and Z30. Well, Viltrox makes that amazing 13mm 1.4 for all three brands, right? Nikon, Fuji and Sony. But hey, not for Canon. You don't deserve a solid fast wide angle lens, because you bought the smallest APS-C sensor brand, 1.6 times crop instead of 1.5 times crop, which is standard. Now look at Sony. I love how Sony has allowed everyone to participate by allowing third-party companies to make lenses. And now we have Sigma, Tamron, Viltrox, and Samyang making stellar products, stellar lenses, because they could make and improve on their first-generation products by working with the E-mount. You see, the 28-75 and the 17-28 f2.8s by Tamron, they're now in their next generations. I think the wide angle zoom is still waiting. We are still waiting for the second generation of that. But they're getting to the second generation lenses, because they could spend time working on the E-mount, building lenses for consumers. They could produce a first set of lenses and then improve on it, right? So they grew with time because Nikon offered them the opportunity. I mean, that's a great service done by Sony. And don't you all tell me that I cannot praise what's praiseworthy about Sony. I think we should all recognize that and we should understand and appreciate that. Sony did cap the performance of third-party lenses for the A1, but hey, most people in most situations do not need more than 15 frames a second. And those that still need that can afford a Sony lens, original Sony lens. But you know, it's not only about affordability anymore. Because the best 85mm Sony lens is actually a Sigma. The best fast zoom on the Sony system is actually a Tamron. Recent Sigma 20mm and 24mm lenses compete with Sony equivalents very, very well. It's crazy. Sony could have gone anti-competition, but they have not. It's just a better strategy, I think. And Fuji learned from it and opened up their Xpound recently. You can argue that Fuji did that after 10 years, and you would be right. You could say that Sony did not have their own lenses, and that's why they allowed others to fill up their lens lineup quickly for them. But what about Nikon? Nikon has every reason that Canon has to protect the mount, but Nikon silently launched the 28-75 f2.8, borrowing the design from Tamron, because they knew the market needed it. Some people wanted it. Right, and they put their trust in the brand. And now they have publicly opened up the mount to Tamron, a company where Sony has a stake. It just shows that Nikon has that overall attitude of serving the consumer base honestly, at least clearly more honestly than Canon, understanding their needs and demands. Nikon did the right thing by producing the best 1.8 primes in the world. In the world. Nothing comes even close to these 1.8 primes. They started at 20mm and went all the way up to 85mm. And all of those lenses, all of those 1.8 primes are fantastic. And then they interspersed the lens lineup with a couple of really good tiny lenses like the 28mm and the 40mm. And 40mm is my favorite. Nikon then also launched the 50mm 1.2. Then they moved to launching some world-beating long lenses and filled out that lineup at almost every price point. By now, we have that fantastic 24-120 f4. Again, unputdownable. They could have stopped Filtrox from making those great APS-C primes for the Z mount, but they did not. Now, we can expect to see all the goodness from Tamron and Filtrox to come to the Z mount. But Canon, man, how disappointing. And to think that they're the largest camera brand with the largest market share. It tells us that they are sitting on the most amount of money of all the camera departments of these companies, right? I mean, Fuji has other businesses. Nikon also has other businesses. So has Sony and Canon. But if you compare the camera departments, I think we can be sure that right now, Canon and Sony are doing the best. So Canon is sitting on money, and despite that, this protectionism, I don't know. I just don't feel great about it. Doesn't give me a great vibe. And I just wanted to talk about that. And I thought, so when I heard that Nikon is opening up the mount to Tamron, I thought, this is the right occasion. This is the right time to actually appreciate these four mounts for what they are, what they offer us, and really set the record right by criticizing Canon where they deserve the right kind of criticism. I think these conversations should happen. A lot of people have been waiting for the 85 1.2 on the Z mount. But if you look at what Nikon has done over the last 2-3 years, the way they've filled up the lens lineup, it's been really, really fantastic. It's been really fantastic. Yes, I'd want the 85 1.2 to come out very quickly. But I don't want Nikon to stop like Canon has at the 85 1.2. I want them to go on and make that 35 1.2 as well. And I know from my audience that a lot of people actually want a 35 1.2. So I don't want Nikon to stop there. All around is looking really, really good. I'm starting to appreciate Sony for what they have done for the recent development in the camera industry. It's just that I think most Sony people, the way they wage war against Nikon, I just don't, I, I don't feel great about it, but otherwise, I'm recording this on a Sony, the A7 IV. I find this to be a really, really, really good camera, and I want Nikon to exceed the capabilities of the A7 IV, and I think they can do it. Anyway, I'm just going off the track right now. Thank you for watching this, and if you like this, you've liked this conversation, then do subscribe. I talk about a whole lot of Nikon, some bit of Fuji, and then Sony. And as you heard today, not much really Canon. And then photography, I love the community that that I think I have been able to build. It's just it's a tiny small community out of 3,000 people probably. I at least know 50 people. I know them by name, and that's a great pleasure, you know, to get to know you guys. So if you like this content, if you like this conversation, do subscribe, do like this video, share, and I'll see you soon with another video.